Hey, hi, welcome to my channel. So today I'll discuss how you can make your GitHub profile beautiful. You can make it better. How is it looking now? So GitHub is an important place which all the developers, testers, or anybody in the IT industry should be aware about, because it's not just about coding. It's a place where people keep their code. So if you are coding, you must know how to use GitHub so that you can easily search your code and people can even reuse it. Don't put the company code, but the one which you do personally or in free time, which can help others, the framework that you have designed, and it can even be used for keeping notes. So without any wasting any time, let's begin. So you will see anybody's profile would be like this, like there will be repository. And so these green symbols are important, that how many check-ins you are doing. So you should do that often, which can come out on your profile. And you see on my profile, I have these things coming as well. So I'll tell you that how you can bring these things in a very easy manner. So I'll tell you conceptually wise, and I'll show you some of the good profiles that I have found out. So for example, this one, how they test. So in this one, there is no code, right? But they have kept a very good notes of like how Airbnb is testing, how Amazon is testing. So you will see no code over there. So GitHub can be used for keeping such notes as well, sharing with people where people can also contribute like that. And now I'll show you some of the profiles. So some of the people's profile, which looks very good and different. So these are some of the profiles. So if you want an image like this, or if you want some symbols like this, so I'll tell you that how you can get all these badges and how you can get this stars and all. Similarly, this is another profile. If you like this, then you may design like this. So how to do that is, so this is my profile. So in the browser, you will see that in the address bar, this is my username. So what you have to do is you simply have to create a repo with the same name. Just click on this new button. Even if you don't have a GitHub account, I'll request you to go and create it. It's not that difficult. So when I give the same name as my username, you will find this message: you found a secret. It's a special repository. Then you can add it as a readme.md file. Since I have already created it, so it's giving me this warning. So don't miss to select this. You can add this file later on as well. Add a readme file. So just click on this and create repo. Then it will look something like this. Since I have already created it, I'll directly show you my profile, my repo. Right. So here, if you see, there is just one file. So here comes the concept of MD, stands for Markdown. So what happens is there is a way of writing a text. Let me show you this. So this is a website, markdownlivepreview.com, where we write a simple text, but by adding some special, like some symbols, not special symbols, like special characters, it becomes like a text. Like in MS Word and all, you have to press Control B and all. Like you must have seen in WhatsApp that putting two stars, it become bold, right? So here, like single pound symbol means it will be coming in H1, and two pound symbol means H2 heading, H3 heading. So similarly on this side, they have explained like how, like here you see that how we can create tables and do all the stuff using this Markdown language. So what you have to do is, let me show you that how I created this Markdown file for myself. So I'm just deleting it and I'm putting my thing. Right. If you see, the same thing which is coming on my profile is displayed over here. So basically that one is getting parsed. Now, how you can do that? So there are three profile generators that I can share with you. So this is Rahul DK Jain. So I'll put it in the comments in the description of this video. So I can put my name over here and I can select what all technologies I'm working on. So then this tool can generate that file for me. For example, I can click on this generate readme and it will generate that MD file for you. I can get the Markdown, right? I can see that if I generate it from this, I'll get a file like this. So what I can do is, once you can do generate readme, right? So just copy this file and you can go to the readme file that you created. click on this edit button, right? And I can replace it like this, and I can commit the changes. Then it will, like, I can even preview it that how is it going to look. So if you see, it's looking like this. If I commit this, the changes will get overridden. So I'm not doing it as of now. Okay, and I'll share you some other simpler ones. So you see that it came back in the normal way. So this is one of the profile generator, right, where your profile is looking like this. Like, you just have to do some selection. You can put your Medium URL, your Twitter, your GitHub user ID, and what all technologies you are working in. For example, suppose I'm working in Python, so it might already be there, Python, so that's why it's not coming. Right, and there is one more. So this is the other one, which is very simpler one. So I have added my username here. So I can just add all these things. So it will keep on adding. So it's just generating a code which is easily understandable. For example, whatever I'm selecting, it is adding some animated badges, which you can change, right? And it is writing in the Markdown style. For example, this GitHub stat, since it's a URL, so you will mention it in brackets. So you can generate these things on your own as well. But if you don't want to generate on your own, then you can maybe use these things. So for example, social, I want to add my LinkedIn profile. So if you see, LinkedIn got added. And if I want to add my Stack Overflow as well, so that will also get appended over here based on what you are adding, and you are adding a valid URL, right? For example, this header. And once I'm done, what I can do is I can copy this and first check it out here, whether it is generated right or not. So you can see here that it got generated like this. So I can paste it in my profile, and I'll show you some of the good profiles from which you can have a learning. For example, this one. So this person, like Abhishek Naidu, he has gathered the profile of various people. And suppose he has classified into this one, like simple but innovative ones. So if you want a particular category, if you want a GIF kind of thing, so he has placed like that. So if you want a profile like this, you can check the README file for this person. Go here, raw, check it out, that how he has done that. So he has put an image like this. So you can have like that if you want. If you want these kind of buttons and all, right, I'll share you a page where all these buttons are present. For example, again, you can go to the README file of this, click on raw, and you can check it out, that from which all sites these things are coming. So this is the site image.shields.io from which these nodes come. Right, so these are, if you want like this, you can have like this. And Anurag, he has explained this, like how you can maybe hide some of the things. For example, you might not want to show all of these details, right? You might not have done those many commits and all, and you don't want to show that. So he has explained like how you can use the hide parameter and all right here, so that accordingly you can create your profile. For example, if you want like this, so anybody's profile you open and you like it, you can see there would be a same name as the username, and then you can open this readme.file and you can see here raw and check it out how they have created that portion. And this is the site shields.io where you can create your banner. For example, I want to write my site name, right, and make a badge. So that badge will look like this if you want to create a custom one, right? So I have shared three profile generators with you, this Markdown thing, and some smileys. If you are a fan of smileys, you can come to this site Emojipedia and have a look at the smileys. Similarly, this simple icons, and there is a website where you can get various icons like Twitter and all. So hope you like the video and you will create a profile like this. Then once you are done and saved, then if you go to your home page, your page will appear like this. So it by default loads your readme.markdown file. So if you like this video, you can subscribe to my channel and look at the various playlists and videos, and do share the link of your GitHub profile. So let's see how innovative you are and how you have made your profile. Thanks for watching.